hashing, and first of all we see why hashing. The purpose of hashing is easy and quick access or search, you can say quick search from the given data. And for instance, let's discuss a problem first and then we see what's the right data structure for this problem. And here's the problem. We have a data set, a table of city codes and city names. So these are the city codes and these are the city names, and we want to store this data in our data structure so that searching of data should be super fast. So right now we have data structures, like we have studied linked list, linked list, array, tree, etc. If you store the data in linked list, you know the complexity of searching in linked list is O of n. And similarly in array, you have to traverse all the elements, so the complexity of searching in array is also O of n. And of course in tree it is less than this, it is log n. But problem with tree is that you have to balance a tree. So what should we do? That we want to make it super fast, we want to make the complexity O of 1. What can we do? You know, there is a data structure where we can search any element with O of 1, that is array. But the condition is we should know the index. If we know the index of the required data member, we can search that data member with complexity O of 1. So this is hashing. What is actually hashing? We use array for hashing, and hashing is actually conversion of key into array index. Suppose the client searched this code. What we will do, we will convert this code somehow to the index of the array, and then we will directly go to that index and we will find this object. So this is array and this is hashing. We convert the key that is user searching into the array index and directly go to that index and find that object. So for instance, these are the data members, data objects we have created, and this is a hash function which we will code in our program. This hash function what it will do, it will simply convert the code into the array index. So here we have used very simple hash function. We have taken mod of this code with the size of the array. Why do we take mod? Mod makes sure that size should not exceed the maximum array index. For instance, you can say, let's write it here. If array size is 10 and we take the mod with a size of 10, suppose this is a key and we take mod with 10, it will never exceed 9. The answer will always be in the range of 0, 1, 2, 3, so on till 9. So this is why we use mod operator, so that the index doesn't exceed the size of the array. And here we have computed the index inside the array. So when we will store this object, when we will store, let me just remove these objects from here. So first of all, we want to store this object into array. We computed its index is 4, so it will be stored in the 4 index. So lower will come here on the 4 index. Then, you know, next object is Bahawalpur. It will come with Bahawalpur. Think there's some change. Let's save it again here. So this is Bahawalpur, and its index should be 1, so it will be placed on this index. So next we have Jalandhar. and it will, its index is 6, so it will be stored at this index 6. So this is quite easy. We simply convert the key into index and we store the index, that object at that index. And we and when we have to find that object, what we will do, we will simply convert the key back to the index and we'll directly go to that index and we will find that object. So but here comes a problem. A problem is, this problem is called collision. How? Like, next we have to store Phagwada and its index is again 1. We have already stored an object with index 1. So what should we do now? Like, here this is Phagwada city, and the index for this object that we computed using the hash function is 1, and this slot is already covered. So in this case we have different options. One option is called open hashing or separate chaining. In this option, what we do, we simply create another linked list on that point. To create another linked list, what we will do, we will add a pointer next in that class of that object, and it will always be null pointer. But using the technique of linked list, we will connect it with its next pointer. So it will come here, and the next pointer of this object will point towards this object. And when we second time get some object with the same index, like here Ujnawala, what we will do, we will simply copy it from it here, paste it here, and we will simply attach it here again. Let me put it there. So actually we will create a linked list here, and next when we get some object with same index like Lailpur, it will be again placed here. So this is called open addressing or separate chaining. As you can say, you attach a linked list with this array of objects. The second option is called probing. Probing, as you can say, closed hashing or open addressing. This has different you can say solutions. One is linear probing. In linear probing, what we do, like in this case, we cite this slot. This slot was already covered. So instead of making a separate chain, what we will do, we will pick this object, and we will go for the second empty slot in this array. So here this slot is empty, although its index is 2, but because we have already covered the slot with index 1, so this object will be placed in this place. So second time we get another object with the same index, we will place it on the next empty slot, I mean here. And then again we find an object with the same index, we will place it on the next empty slot, that is here. So this is called a linear probing. And in linear probing, as you have observed, we form a cluster. So like this one index has made a cluster at this point. We have 3 objects with the same index. So this has covered the slot of 2 and this has covered the slot of 3. So next, if we get some object with index 2 or 3, like here we do not have any object with index 2 or 3, these slots will already be covered. So we will have to find some other place. Like say you get an object with index 2, and let's put it name as Sahiwal. So although 2 didn't occur before, but the slot for 2 is already covered, 3 is already covered, 4 is already covered, 5 is already covered, 6 is also covered. So we will place it at this slot. So this is a problem with open addressing with linear probing, that you make a cluster. So to avoid this cluster, we have another technique that is called quadratic probing. Here, instead of when we find an empty slot, we do not increment index one by one. Instead, we increment it by using the square root. Like, first of all, it will go index into index plus one. Its square, that will be one. Next time, it will take two square, that will be four. And next time, it will take three square, it will be nine. So this time, so this way, instead of linearly moving to find the empty slot, we will taking squares and we will actually jumping over the cells. So this is so this way we will avoid the clustering, and we will reach the end of the array. We will go back to the start of the array to find the empty slot. So this was an introductory lecture on hashing, and stay tuned for the next lecture. And in the next lecture, we will do some programming in C++ to implement all these techniques like linear probing, quadratic probing, and separate chaining, where we will be using a separate linked list to connect to the collided slot. So stay tuned for the next lecture.